As we offer a welcome to strangers and friends, as we are embraced in their kindness, we choose to be people of the life and blessing. As we serve others in God's name, as we receive blessings from those we do not know, we choose to walk in God's way. As we forgive those that have hurt us, as we reach out to those we have harmed, we choose to be conceived to our sisters and brothers. Let us worship together. Let us pray. God of Christ Jesus and our God, lift us above the mundane to the special, beyond the empty platitudes to sincere praise, and awake in us the adoration which is the joy of loving hearts. You are the God of grace and glory. We are yours, and by the miracle of grace, you are ours. Blessed be your name in all the earth. Amen. With every choice, we show how faithful we are to God's hope for us. Yet despite the mistakes we make, the missteps we take, God remains forgiving and gracious. Let us come to our God, speaking honestly about our lives as we pray together. Let us pray the unison prayer of confession. How often we make our wrong choices, God, of our lives. We look at others through the prism of lust, distorting who they really are. We let our mad free us from bitterness and hurt. We toss about harmful words like so many snowballs on a winter's day. We would rather insult those around us than to lift them up. Have mercy on us, God, who is everywhere. May we set aside our quarreling natures to be united in common worship, common service, and common purpose as we follow Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Christ came so that we may be healed by God's tender touch. Christ came as we might be reconciled to one another. Thanks be to God. As risky, as hard as it may be, we will choose to be God's people. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pass the peace together. Congregation, please be seated. Just a few announcements this morning. That Sam's Club plans a Valentine's dinner, and there's been a lot of people signed up. And it's Wednesday, February 15th at 5:30 in Scheide Hall. It's a nice dinner. It's going to be catered by Joe Gianni. There is a cost of $8 per person, but that includes everything. Stuffed chicken breasts, mashed potatoes, some nice vegetables, dessert, and beverage. And I just encourage you to sign up. If you're double nickels and up, you're in. So I hope that people can attend. Along with the other announcements, College Fellowship will be meeting tonight at 7 o'clock in our home. The time varies. It depends on some of our college students and if they can make it at a certain time. So sometimes you'll see it at 8:30 in the bulletin, but the time does vary. The women's Bible study is off to a great start with their Bible study, and I'm sure they'd like more to attend. So if you have an inclination to be part of the Bible study, I'm sure that Aaron would love to have you. As we go to God in prayer this morning, I ask that we keep Jean Spence in our prayers. She has a tumor, a growth behind her ear. She told me I could share this, and we ask prayer for her as she deals with this cancer. I want us to pray for a friend down the street. His name is Jerome Orsdorf. He is the youth pastor at the Methodist Church. I've known him for a long time. He is in a Pittsburgh hospital right now, and they are not quite sure, but they are very concerned about his illness. Austin Kalaja asked us that we pray for his 3-year-old cousin. Knightley is his name, and he's had seizures. And then also another request that came from Eric Fenske this morning, his grandma Florence, we ask that you pray for her. She is in hospice care in Buffalo. And so these are our concerns and our prayers this morning. Thank you. Oh, I guess I do have to pray. I'm sorry, a little nervous. Let us pray together. Dear Lord, we praise you this very morning. We praise you in this very moment. As we gather to worship this very hour, we know as Christian believers that you, O God, are present with us. In the very presence, there is a total sense of comfort and joy, a sense of your love and joy within us all. Lord, this day you lead, and we will truly follow. Help us to face the challenges ahead this week and to overcome the obstacles. Forgive us, Lord, when we stray. We stray from your presence, from your love. Lord, you tell us in your word to consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Lord, there are some loved ones, and we've mentioned their names, and they are going through trials. Please, Lord, be with them, guide them, bless them. Oh, Lord, that it is so much harder for us to face trials. However, you do not call us to do this alone. And this is why this can be a joy in the challenges we face. Because, Lord, you are there. You are present. Forgive us for our wrongs. Help us to do what is right. We pray for our church and our leadership. We pray for our community, our nation. And we pray for each other, for our families. Help us to be ever mindful of each other and to love one another as Christ loves us. O Lord, hear our prayers. Help us to see clearly what is within our heart and what is within our heart, you know and accept us as we are. Lord, you are our comfort and our strength. Lift up your people and those that are sick. I pray for Jerome, Lord. I pray for Gene. I pray for Knightley, just that little baby boy, Lord. I pray, too, for our loved ones, Lord, our grandmas. I pray for Eric's grandmother as she deals with hospice. And, Lord, I pray that you would be ever present with the family. Bless her and keep her. Lord, comfort her. I pray in your name. Hear our prayers in Jesus' name, the one who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Will you join me in the prayer of illumination? O God, by your Spirit, tell us what we need to hear and show us what we ought to do to obey Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The Old Testament lesson is Isaiah 12. I will praise you, Lord. Although you were angry with me, your anger has turned away, and you have comforted me. Surely God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. The Lord himself is my strength and my defense. He has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. Give praise to the Lord. Proclaim his name. Make known among the nations what he has done, and proclaim that his name is exalted. Sing to the Lord, for he has done glorious things. Let this be known to all the world. Shout aloud and sing for joy, people of Zion, for great is the Holy One of Israel among you. And the Psalter lesson is Psalm 47. Clap your hands, all you peoples. Shout to God with loud songs of joy. For the Lord, the Most High, is awesome, a great king over all the earth. He subdued peoples under us and nations under our feet. He chose our heritage for us, the pride of Jacob whom he loves, Selah. God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King, sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth. Sing praises with a psalm. God is King over the nations. God sits on his holy throne. The princes of the peoples gather as the people of the God of Abraham. For the shields of the earth belong to God. He is highly exalted.
And also reading from the New Testament, James chapter 1, beginning with verse 2. My brothers and sisters, whatever you face trials of any kind, consider it nothing but joy, because you know that the testing of your faith produces endurance. And let endurance have its full effect, so that you may be mature and complete, lacking in nothing. If any of you is lacking in wisdom, ask God, who gives to you all generously and ungrudgingly, and it will be given to you. And then reading also from Romans chapter 5, verses 1 through 5. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to the grace in which we stand, and we boast in hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. This ends the reading of God's word.
Thanks be to God.
Now I'd like the children to come forward, But I want you to sit up here with me, right over here. Okay? Because Mr. Newcombe, he's a sitter. He's not a stander. But come on up. Don't be afraid. I know you haven't seen me up here in a while. Now, I've got a joy bag. And there's lots of things that say joy. Yep. Is this where I find joy? What does that say?
Joy.
And what is it?
I don't know.
Dish soap.
Yeah.
Now, I suppose if I'm doing the dishes and it's ultra joy, Mrs. Newcombe finds a little joy in the fact that I'm doing the dishes, but that doesn't really bring you joy, does it?
Yeah.
Even if we'd fill this up and make bubbles out of it. Well, that would be fun, but I don't know if it's pure joy. Now, this is almond joy. And why don't you like almond joys? You don't like almonds, that's right. And you know what else is in almond joys? Coconut. I know, I hear you, sister. There, you know, but I like almonds. But that says almond joy. Wouldn't that bring me joy? Would this bring us joy? Maybe if we eat it and like it. I know some people out in the audience that like almond joys. So, there we go. Now, I've got in my joy bag the word joy. Did you know that sometimes people name their daughters Joy? Did you know that?
No.
Yeah, they do. It might be an old name versus a newer name. But joy. Well, what do you see in joy? How do you find joy? How do you find joy in your life? Is there any way you find joy? What do you think? Do you find joy in playing with your baby sister? Kind of. Okay. Do you find joy in playing with your friends?
Kind of.
Do you find joy when you go to Sunday school?
Kind of.
Okay. A lot of kindness. Well, we can find joy in many things. In our relationships. In our friendships. But where do you think we find joy most of all? It's certainly not in the candy or the soap, even though it says joy on there.
In our
hearts. Oh, yes. And how do we find joy in our hearts? With the love of Jesus. There's a joy, joy, joy down in my heart. And that is the love of Jesus Christ. So if you've learned anything by this simple children's moments, the joy of loving Jesus is the most important thing that we can have. Would you pray with me? Dear Lord, we thank you for your love. Help us to be joyful in our relationship with you. Amen. Thank you very much.
Maybe some of you adults
get the almond joys later. Because I knew they wouldn't like them. I'd like to talk to you. I guess you probably already guessed it, but humor me a little bit. I'd like to talk to you this morning about a three-letter word that seems that we seem to strive for. We desire it. We want to maintain it, the purpose of that word, in our everyday lives, which may or may not be obtainable, an obtainable goal or a realistic goal at all. We want the word for our families, our friends, and for ourselves. We may even desire the word for strangers, for people who are hurting, are sick. It is a word and a concept that is not hard to understand, and we can find it in the Bible. It's a word we talk and sing about at Sunday school, and perhaps even in our after-school program, Transformational Tuesdays. The word is found in the sounds and voices when I pass by the nursery and the children are at play, or when I'm sitting at my desk and the children come through, pass through the church office, and sometimes they share their song or share something with us, and you know there's joy in their voices. Now, on the other side of the wall in my office are the women's Bible studies. And during Tuesday's woman Bible study, when I hear them laughing and talking with each other, a little friendly banter, I hear this word. The three-letter word is evident there in the midst of our men's breakfast, our men's Bible study. We have such a great time gathering together in fellowship, in excellent camaraderie with each other. We study God's word. Now you might be saying, come on, Nuke, you already gave it up. What's that simple three-letter word? Well, you might have already figured it out, like the young woman in my college group by the name of Cammie. Of course, the three-letter word is joy. And this morning, I would like to explore that word joy. Now, I suppose I could look it up on the internet for a definition, but I like old school. The word joy is defined in the Webster's New World Dictionary as a very glad feeling, as happiness, delight, anything that might cause joy. In the New Testament book of James, it is present in quite a different view of the meaning of joy. And in the scripture this morning that James read, and in the scripture that I read, James tells us to consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith develops what? Perseverance. And perseverance will finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking in anything. James calls for joy on facing of our trials and our problems. It may seem to shock a person like you and me at first, but as you read and understand, James finds joy in the result of his trials. I would say in your life, even in the most difficult times, that good qualities can and will be produced, but you must be open to them. We must be opened. As a person is persevering through tough times, that person can recognize the wrongdoing and repent, turning away from, asking forgiveness. Truly, a redemptive spirit is vital in realizing that you and I must make a change. And within that change, we can recognize the joy. We must trust and glorify God in all that we say, in all that we do. The people of this great congregation must see each other in love and respect, glorifying God. Let me say that once more. The people of this great congregation that you've been associated with for a long time or just a short period of time must see each other in love and respect for one another, glorifying God. We must put our joy on, again, loving and respecting each other. We should demonstrate trusting in Jesus brings great joy and brings us closer together in the unity of our Lord and to do the Lord's will. The most important point, however, is that the joy of Christ in others, to see the joy of Christ in others in our own lives. Do the young adults that I shepherd in the college fellowship see the joy of Christ in my life? Or am I like Josh McDowell refers to, a cosmic killjoy? Do the senior adults that I love being with see the love and joy of Christ in each other's lives and in mine? Does my own family see the love of Christ in my life? Well, don't always ask David. Because David, I love my son with all my heart, but he's brutally honest. The simple fact is, do the people that we come in contact with, you and me, see a judgmental person? Are we all about the judgment? And a person who wants to avoid each other, avoid us? Or is it a person who is loving and accepting, a child of God who wants to spread the love of Christ to others? Simply put, do we recognize the joy of Christ in us and, most importantly, ourselves? Do we wrestle too much with joy of Christ in our lives? Are we so uptight sometimes that we forget why we even gather together here in this church? To worship the Lord. To worship the Lord Jesus. Forgetting the joy of Christ and each other. One of my favorite movies in recent years, you know, I know, some people, they quote great books. I'm into great movies. One of my favorite movies in recent years is Facing the Giants. I know the college students have seen it more than once. I'm sure the Sam's Club group has watched it with me. It has a great storyline where the young coach of a football team is facing personal challenges, such as not having much success in winning games and not being able to support his family because they don't pay him very much. The coach and his wife are having trouble conceiving a child. There is a group that wants him to resign, or better yet, would like to fire him. And the list goes on and on and on. So in facing these overwhelming obstacles and challenges, he goes back to what he knows for certain and faces his problems head on by turning back to the one sure thing, his relationship with Jesus Christ and the love of God. He falls to his knees in prayer. He turns over everything to God and faces his problems, not alone, but in the arms of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And we should do the same. One of my favorite lines from the movie is when the coach says to his football players, while trying to instill a new attitude, a positive, hardworking attitude, he says, if we win, we glorify God. If we lose, we glorify God. That's the most important point, is not about the winning and losing, but glorifying God no matter what. You see, we must glorify God as the people of God in good times and in tough times. And if we are winning or losing, whether we're successful or unsuccessful, we must glorify God. We must express our joy no matter what circumstances or challenges we face. I'm not saying put a false smile on your face. I am not saying fake it until you make it. What I'm saying is glorify God. Put your trust in Him. How about the young couple whose husband may face a layoff, but they face it with God and each other? How about the couple who has known each other since they were teenagers and married for many, many, many years and are faced with health issues? They are a great example to us all because they faced the challenges all through their years. They faced them. How about the person who lost their spouse but continues to trust in the Lord, not losing sight of their joy? Maybe they can't express that joy all the time, but they have not lost sight of Jesus Christ and the joy of Christ. I am personally learning a lot from the people that I am involved with, the senior adults. They're great people. When we play cards and they spat a little, they have a little argument among each other sometimes. But I just love them. The godly men and women in our congregation who have had the opportunity to visit. They're loyal and supportive. They're loyal and supportive to their spouses. And even though they may have health issues at their own, they are more concerned not about their own issues, but about their significant other. When we face extremely tough circumstances, I've learned that it is better to face things together with hope and joy in Jesus Christ, as a church, as a community, as a family. You do not face tough issues alone, comforting and joyful, knowing that Christ is with us. We must examine our attitudes with each other and with our church family, our own families. In the movie Facing the Giants, the coach has a great line in the movie. He says, your attitude is like the aroma of your heart. If your attitude stinks, then the aroma of your heart does too. Give God your very best with your attitude, with one another, in your word and deed. And then the aroma of your heart is truly pleasing to God. We can lead a joyful Christian life for Christ by giving the life totally to the Lord. One evening on one of the news shows, a commentator told us about three young adults, their extreme love for Jesus Christ and the importance of their Christian walk. The one was a Victoria's Secret model. Her name was Callie Pasuti. She was interviewed on Good Morning America, and the reason she gave up quitting modeling for Victoria's Secret was the influence it was having on young women, especially her own young cousin, who said she needed to stop eating so she could look like her. Although Pasuti says her days as a Victoria's Secret model are history, she hasn't hung up modeling shoes yet. The young woman is still pursuing modeling, but she wanted to do more wholesome modeling. And the jobs that she chooses will be honoring the Lord, she said. Another young adult is an NBA player, is Jeremy Lin, who plays for the Brooklyn Nets. And he is vocal about his love for Jesus. And we can't mention somebody being vocal about their love for Christ and not mention Tim Tebow, who now, instead of playing an NFL quarterback, he's in the New York Mets organization in baseball. The focus that all three of these young people have is a dependency on their relationship with Christ, knowing that their lives are in the spotlight, but most important and vital is their desire to follow Christ. Their desire to follow Christ and to be a good example of Christ in their attitude and their action and the joy for God. I'm impressed with people, even the famous athletes who celebrate and the celebrities see the importance of accepting Christ. Their Lord and Savior is important to them, and equally impressive is the fact that they want to express the joy for Christ. They are willing to share that joy with others. My challenge in prayer as we leave this place this morning is let's be a joyful people, a joyful Christian people, and share the joy and the love of Jesus Christ with each other and others beyond these doors, so that people can see the joy of Christ in our lives and want what you and I have, that joy of Christ. God bless this simple message in His name. Amen. Would the congregation please be seated? Let us have the affirmation of faith and say it together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The world is a mess. What can we do? We can offer our visions of hope, our words of comfort, our acts of love, our resources to help bring about God's new heaven and new earth. Please join me in the offertory prayer. Gracious God, as we are present these offerings, we are you have shared with us as individuals and as a community of believers. You have fed us with the milk of your grace, and you have nurtured us with the love that knows no limits and boundaries. May our sharing this day reveal our priorities and our promises, for we belong to you. Offer our gifts, that they may be used in mission and in ministry to bring glory to God, our Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us build this house together. Let us dwell in this house together. As we part from this house, let us be joyful in all that we say, in all that we do, as brothers and sisters of Christ. Amen.